Welcome to the course on Test Your C Programming Skills, a guide to crack IT interview. We are discussing third topic of this course, that is arrays and pointers, and this is third session on the strings. Let's get started with first example of this session. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a character array str which is storing the content by, and there is a for loop which is printing the content of str in a different ways. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program gives the output as a BBBYYY and followed by EEE. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Note that here three different syntax are used to access content of nth element from the character array str. These syntaxes are str in the rectangular bracket n, star in the bracket str plus n, and n in the bracket str. So all three are the valid syntax to access nth element from the character array. And that's why each character of the array is displayed thrice in the output. Also note that in the for loop, the condition is str n. So this condition ensures that this loop executes till the time we are reaching the null character. And that's why the output is as shown. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a character pointer str which is storing the content welcome. And there is a string compare library function call which is comparing the content of str with welcome. If the if condition is true, it is displaying the message equal. If condition is false, then it is displaying the message unequal. So the correct output of this program is unequal. Let's understand why we are getting unequal as output of this program. Note that string compare library function returns the value 0 if both strings are equal. In this case, the content of str and another string is welcome. The content is equal. So that's why this function returns 0 and if condition becomes false. So else condition is executed and that displays the message unequal. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a character array str1. Which is containing the message welcome. There is a character pointer str2 which is containing the message all, and string concat function is called on line number 7, and finally we are displaying the content of str1 on line number 8. So the correct answer of this program is, it will give the output as a welcome all. Let's understand why we are getting the welcome all as output of this program. Note that here str1 is a character array and it is having size equal to 20. The library function strcat concat string str2 to str1, and hence the output is welcome all. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. This code is similar to the previous example with one difference. Here str1 is not a character array, but it is a pointer to string. The rest all code is exactly same as that of a previous example. So the correct answer of this program is, it gives the message as a garbage. Let's understand why we are getting garbage as a output of this program. Note that str1 is a string literal and it is stored in read-only data segment. Line number 7 is attempting to append a new content to str1. So it is trying to modify the content of string str1, which is not allowed. Hence, output of this program is unpredictable, that is garbage. Note that this program gives the output welcome all if we execute this program with the help of Turbo C compiler. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a character pointer str. And this pointer str is assigned to the string welcome. And on line number 7, there is a printf, which is printing content of the str using %c. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives the output as a welcome. Let's understand why we are getting welcome as output of this program. Note that here str1 is a pointer to constant character string. Hence, string content cannot be changed. However, pointer can be made to point to some other string. So that's why expression on line number 7 is correct. In expression, that is *str1++, both operators, that is star as well as plus, are having same precedence. However, associativity in this case is right to left. So +++ is applied first and then star. %c handles the string content one character at one time. Due to post increment, the content of str1 is displayed first and then pointer is moved to the next location. And that's why it displays the message welcome. So coming next is, we'll have the fourth session on the strings. Till then, enjoy C programming.